The main problems we're looking at is with cucurbits is fusarium, wilt in the soil. But we also have other problems in the soil. We have root knot nematode, which is a major concern. And we don't have anything that can combat that either. So those two combinations are a major threat to our vegetable industry, especially the watermelon industry out the country. With grafting, we're finding that we can improve yields, improve quality of the fruit, and we're also looking at holding ability within the field. We're also increasing, for example, the lycopene in the fruit of a watermelon. So there's a lot of advantages to grafting other than overcoming soil-borne diseases. Working jointly with the USDA, we've released one rootstock of watermelons. It's a U.S. now rootstock that has both resistance to all races of fusarium and root knot nematode, and that's the first one of its kind. Grafting's been going on in the world for over 60 years, but it's very labor intensive, so we're looking at ways that we can graft that will help eliminate the costs involved. What we've developed is a process of killing the growing point on these by application of a fatty alcohol, so that plant no longer grows, but it keeps going because those cotyledon leaves are actually functioning leaves. So by in about a week's time, we can cut it off. What that gives you advantage is you don't have any what's called regrowth of the rootstock. By killing that growing point and eliminating that growing point, and also by being able to build up the carbohydrates in there, we can graft right below it. We can also automate that with a grafting robot that does exactly that, only grafts perfect to this without the need of that cotyledon leaf. And so we can speed up the whole process with automation. So what we're developing is grow rooms with artificial light. And then we also have a healing chamber with artificial light, so that we're trying to develop a cookbook or recipe that with this amount of light and this temperature, we can grow this rootstock consistently to grafting stage in this many days. And then the same thing to get an ideal top growth and the same amount of time. So we're trying to eliminate as many factors, yet we're trying to come up with a formula so we can mass produce those plants consistently, and so that we have 100% grafted take every time. And so we've cut the cost of grafting tremendously by this new method that we've developed.